Then, when you say 10% of the Indian population has received the COVID vaccine, so I'm sure all of you would have heard something about the COVID vaccine. So, if this is India, we say 10%, so very small amount. So, 10% is also very low. Okay. So, yeah, you've already given me examples. I got a very good example of report cards. I think it's the most obvious place where you would have seen a percentage. So now let's take an example to understand percentages in a better manner. So let's say we have a chakki. It's something you eat. I think all of you would have heard of it. And I have put an image of a chakki on the right as well. So can two of you just tell me your names quickly or write it in the chat box? Let's say we have a chair has 7 by 10 of the chicky and Joe has 15 by 20 of the chicky. Now we have to decide who got more chicky. Okay. So when we say 7 by 10, it basically means that we have a chicky, we break it into 10 parts, and from 10 parts, we take 7 parts. Okay, so when we say that Jay has 7 by 10 and Dhruv has 15 by 20, both these fractions have different denominators. Okay, so the piece they got would also have a different size. So we cannot directly compare them and just say that because Dhruv got 15 pieces and Jay got 7 pieces, Dhruv got more than Jay. We have to have equal sizes. So Anjali says that let's cut the chikki into 100 parts. So the chikki Jay has will also be cut into 100 parts, and the chikki Dhruv has will also be cut into 100 parts. And obviously now both of them will have pieces which have the same size. Easily compare them. Jay got 7 by 10 of a chikki, so we broke the large piece into 10 pieces, and from those 10 pieces, Jay ate 7 pieces, which are shaded with a yellow color. Now, on the previous slide, Anjali had said that we have to break it into 100 so that we can compare it easily. So that's what we'll do right now. We have broken the chikki into 100 pieces. So now this piece, which was one earlier, has now become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So each of those pieces has been broken into 10 more pieces. So now we in total have 100 pieces. And can someone tell me how many pieces does Jay have now? Very good. So Jay now has 70 pieces. You say that Now we had Dhruv. Dhruv got 15 out of 20 pieces. Now, for each of these pieces, for us to get a total of 100, I will break it up into 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 pieces over here. So now, similarly, if we break up the entire chikki like this, we get something like this. Okay? So this became something out of 100. Now, can someone tell me what this is?
Somebody else. Come on. Yeah, Vivek.
75.
Very good. This is 75. So, on the previous slide, we had seen that Jay got 70 out of 100 and Dhruv got 75 out of 100. Obviously, Dhruv got. We'll just write down here. Jay got 70 out of 100 and Dhruv got 75 out of 100. So our question was, who has more chikki? Answer to that obviously now is Dhruv. Now let us try understanding percentages through one more example. Let's say there's a school which has 25 students. Out of those 25 students, 5 students eat oranges only. They don't like eating anything, only oranges. And the other 20 like apples only. The people who like oranges don't like apples. The people who like apples don't like oranges. So remember we said that we'll make everything out of 100. Here, let's cut the chikki into 100 pieces. Now we'll make everything out of 100 only. We'll do that the same over here. So we'll do the same over here. We said that there are total of how many fruits? 25 fruits, 5 oranges plus 20 apples. But we want to convert it into something by 100. And we need to find what that something is. So it says that 5 oranges and 20 apples are brought every day. So let's say this is day 1. On day 1, we got 25 fruits, out of which 5 are oranges. But now we want 100 fruits. So what if we make copies of this? Of this thing we have here. Now, how many copies of this should I make to get 100 fruits?
Four.
Very good. So we make one more copy. We make one more copy. This is day 3. And we finally make one last copy. This is day 4. So now in total we have 100 fruits, which is what we wanted. And out of that, we have 20 oranges. So we can say basically the percentage of oranges is 20%, which we'll cover in the next slide. So the word per basically means, okay, I want you to tell me what the word per means. I eat one chapati per day.
Per means one thing.
Yeah, one thing. Okay, very good. So basically, per means for every. Okay. And one thing which you said is also correct. But here we say for every. Let's say, I'll take a few examples to understand. Let's say we say I spend rupees 100 per day. Now here per means for every day. For every day I spend rupees 100. Now someone came here and said one thing. That is also correct. But for every bad way to say this. Okay, so absolutely correct. Just that for every, because it sounds better and it fits better in the context which we are talking about. And cent means 100. So the important thing you have to remember, this will be very important for throughout this chapter, is that the word percentage means for every 100.